All right, welcome back to another World of Warcraft leveling episode. Let's grab this. Hey, 32. Wish I unlocked anything at 32. How exciting, what a wonderful new system. I sure do love the new talent system. I did actually hit 30, so I should probably learn Enraged Regeneration. Did not go into my bars. It sounded like it did, but it did not. Shift S seems like a good enough spot for it. Man, I sure am glad I'm 32 instead of 31, so I can get, you know, an incredibly marginal stat upgrade that's invisible to me. Fucking love the new talent system. Anyway. So what last time we talked about fucking making golden WoW, which is a thing that I feel I'm reasonably good at.
Need help?
You need help. Fuck you. That's actually, if this shield was bigger, I'd be all over it. But it looks kind of fucking dumb.
Be careful.
Because it's so tiny.
You got my attention?
You got my attention. Yeah, give me that shit.
Watch your back.
Watch your back. See you soon. Alright, which one is this just better than? Ring of the Fool. That's the one. Get out of my character. Alright, so let's go do these troll things. I know I said I was pretty much only doing this and not skipping straight to Cape because of the Nessingwary chain, but I mean, I'm here. Fuck it. It's really not a far distance at all. And even though it is underleveled, it still gives me a nice chunk of experience. It's not completely useless. Oh, hello, High Encoding. Also known as Hello Darkness, my old friend. This one's lasting a while. It's probably looking real choppy. Sorry for that. Oh. There we go. Oh. Excuse me. Is my mouse fucked up? What just happened? Sorry, that's me unplugging my mouse and plugging it back in. There we go. My mouse just fucked up. That was so weird. Like, it just suddenly was like, I don't know. It just decided to unplug itself, I guess. I don't know, that was very weird. Yeah, I have no explanation. That was just fucking weird. Alright, I have an explanation. Saying I have no explanation is definitely not correct. The explanation is, my mouse cord is really fucked up. It's not a good explanation, but it's an explanation, you know? Boop, boop. You, get over here. Alright, killed everything. Still have to kill more, though. Alright, don't have to kill more Beastmasters, which is good. Gotta kill some Hunters, so let's just hop in here and do it. Hello, Mystic. Alright, so we need one more Hunter, three more Scouts, and three more Mystics. I can do this. Alright, one more Hunter. Hello. Need one more scout, some more mystics. Here's some mystics. Isn't heroic throw, doesn't it supposedly silence? Or is that a glyph now or something? Definitely used to silence. I don't know what the deal is right now. No, whatever, let's just aggro these guys. Uh, So we need one more scout. Hey, that's you. For some reason in my brain I had this guy as a hunter. And that is not true. Alright, that's nice. Can I climb up on this? I sure hope so. Nope. Alright, going the long way. Boop-a-doop boop. Boop-a-doop-boop. Beebly boop bop boop. Alright. I do like all of the troll stuff that exists in Stranglethorn. It's really cool. All of it's just really cool. I fucking love Stranglethorn. Hey, idiots. Wanna fucking battle? Alright. So that's that. Okay, this is perfect. So I can run over here, turn in, and then I can flight path down here, kill. Easy peasy. Lemon squeezy. And then I can fly back, of course. Everything will be great. I really wish there were less casters here. And if there were less casters here, well, less ranged dudes in general, I would consider literally just rounding up a shitload of dudes and killing them. Because Revenge and Thunderclap are pretty good AoE abilities. Revenge is only on 3 targets, right? Yeah. But it's still very high damage, so every Revenge would probably just kill 3 dudes. Which would make it hit severely larger numbers of dudes every time I use it. Or percentagely larger amounts of dudes in the packs. Doom 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 doom. Bloom 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 bloom. Also, the music, I'm certain the music is quite quiet for you, so excuse me while I just embrace it. I don't know if people want to actually hear the music super loud. I tend to not give a shit about game sounds in general. I just like them to be there at all, and I think I have the sound balance in a way that appeals to me, but everybody has different preferences when it comes to that sort of thing. Some people want the game sound to be equal volume to the commentator, which I disagree with wholeheartedly. I think that's the worst sound balance you can do. Well, the only thing worse than it is having game sound louder than the person talking. That's the only way that you could go worse than having them equal. I would always prefer to have silence instead of equal levels of game sound and person talking. My, you're a tall one. What does this look like? Looks kinda interesting. Actually, that's worth noting. Ow. Hello, Bloodlord. Ah, that's right. Oh, yeah. Forgot about this. Pleased to meet you. Yeah, we're gonna do this. I'm excited for this bit. So if you don't know what this is, first of all, that's Bloodlord Mandic here, the dude who used to drop the raptor that I like to ride around on. He's got some raptor fetish or something. I don't quite understand it. But there is a chain of quests in Northern Stranglethorn, beginning in Fort Livingston, well, beginning, back here at the Rebel Camp, but continuing in Fort Livingston, where you essentially go into uninstanced Zul'Gurub as that Lashtail hatchling, which is cool. And it's a puzzle thing, and the puzzles are bullshit, but once you know them, they're super easy, because they're really bad. They're really poorly done, but it's still a cool concept, and I like it. And it's also adorable, because you get to play as a tiny little baby raptor, which is so fucking cute. And I will do that after I take care of these stupid, big, dumb, idiot faces. Fucking Bangladesh and you know, stupid old dude. Just a skull on a sign. Yeah, seems reasonable. I've never gone in there. I assume you insta-die, but I've never, like, you know, mustered up the fucking strength to go there. Why are you so weak now, Bangladesh? It makes me sad. You used to be a really difficult enemy to kill. I liked that. And they did the same thing with the Outland quests. They probably did the same thing with the Northrend ones for Nessingwary, where they used to be all elites and really difficult, and now they're just like, yeah, they're regular. Like killing, God, which is the final one in Nagrand? Who's the final one in Nagrand? Is it the Clefthoof or the Elic? Wait. Fuck, I think it's the Elic, right? I think it's a big ol' Elic. Or is that part of the Ethereal's questline? I think it's the Elic. I'm pretty sure it's the Elic, right? Because you have the Windrock Mastery, you have the Clefthoof Mastery, and the Tallbuck Mastery. And then you kill the Mega One of each of those three, which all used to be elites. And then you kill the Super Ultra Mega Elite, which is not any of those types of animals, which means I'm fairly certain it's the Elic, who also used to be an elite and terrifying. And so did, shit, what's his name? The giant Gron, who's in Nagrand, who wanders around Oshugan. That guy also, Dern the Hungerer, I think. That sounds right. That guy used to be elite and really hard to kill, and now he's got like 5,000 hit points, and then you just kill him in 2 seconds. Doesn't matter. Actually, 5,000 might be... No, that seems reasonable, I think. Yeah, that seems like a low number. I believe it's that. Oh well.
Time is money, friend.
Yeah, it is.
What's on your mind?
What's on your mind? Hey, give me that.
Watch your back.
Yeah, the Green Hills of Stranglethorn. There we go. So yeah, it looks like the book parts of the quest, the book chain seems to be gone. Although you probably, if you pick up the pages, they probably give you a quest to turn in, and that's probably a different Stranglethorn related quest. But I'm not certain. Oh yeah, Fiona's traveling party. We might do that. I might do Eastern Plaguelands. I only kind of did this quest once since it got added, and it's very interesting. So I might do that. It's a really cool chain. Although what's really upsetting about it is that if you're Horde and you do it, because it's neutral in Eastern Plaguelands, and then in Warlords of Draenor they added Fiona and the caravan. However, here's the catch. In Warlords of Draenor, they're alliance only. So if you're Horde, you can't continue the story, if you will. You know, you have to just sit there, and Fiona gets real mad at you. And Fiona is a organ, by the way. And the weird thing is that the caravan has, I think there's a blood elf and a goblin, right? So it doesn't make sense for them to be alliance only, but they are, which is most likely just an oversight. But, I mean, in fairness, they are in Shadowmoon Valley, which no Hordies go to until they're, like, level capped and or have flying and, you know, doing shit, like a garrison fishing quest, for example. That requires you to be in Shadowmoon. But, yeah, it's just kind of a weird thing that it's neutral in Eastern Plaguelands and then the exact same characters in a future place are no longer neutral.
May the light embrace you.
What can I do for you?
Oh geez, that's a lot of stuff. Wait.
I got a bad feeling.
To the cape. Yeah, I want that one. I don't think I want these though.
Watch your back.
Well, yeah, I don't think I want these. Ah, fuck it, whatever, let's take them all. It's like he's trying to be Batman, except he's really bad at it. Where is she? That's not a good Batman. In fact, that's probably worse than his Batman. I apologize for that one. My voice isn't really up for Batman right now. So, sorry that it fell short. Man, I sure do love kill and collect quests with not 100% drop rate. They sure are the best, huh? Good news is they're not super low drop rate. They're just not very good drop rate. Also, these guys are 26. Yeah, I should probably get to the cape. Like, every one of these things, right? I'm like, oh, I'll get to the cape. Yeah, no, I'll do it. It's just that I want to do this one last thing. Oh, no, I'll do this one last thing. No, this one. How about this one? Yeah, we'll stop on this one and then go to the cape. By the time that I'm ready to go to the cape, I'll be overleveled for that shit. In fact, I already am. Almost. Because it's supposed to be, you know, to 35 or whatever. And I'm already 34. Or 33, sorry. Whatever. My brain works in mysterious ways. I apologize. Damn it. Give me a fucking feather, you assholes. Thanks. I guess I just had to ask. Alright, so what exact... I don't recall these things. The Mosh-Og bounty. Do I have to go up over here, I think? Or is that a pathway leading to it? That looks like a pathway leading to it. But I'm not certain. In fact, I'm fairly uncertain. Yeah, it looks like this is the correct way to go. Yep, there it is. Mosh-Og bounty, and then the mind's eye is in the cave. I gotta kill a dude, right? And then the dude I'm killing drops it. The Myzoth. You know what I do really like, by the way? So a lot of people are spending their time complaining about, like, Warlords of Draenor stuff, and I recently, as in today, started doing LFR Highmaul. Well, finished doing LFR Highmaul. For the Legendary Ring quest, of course, and I love... So I've always really liked ogre stuff, right? I've always thought ogres were a very unique race, you know? So the thing about ogres, if you don't really know much about them, the main thing that I find interesting is that, you know, some ogres are born with two heads. The ogres that are born with two heads are by default magi, because they're smarter than other ogres because they have two heads, which is so funny to me. And it might be funny to most people. In fact, it probably is funny to most people. It's a comedic thing. But what makes ogres so interesting is that, you know, you see them as these like big bumbling brutes, you know, and then there's these magi who feel so out of place. It feels like, you know, it just kind of got forced on them or whatever, because, you know, they're big bumbling brutes with two heads, right? They don't seem like the magi type. And then, right, and then there's actual like fucking crazy ass ogre magis who like have a lot of crazy sort of dark stuff surrounding them. I mean, Cho'Gall is a great example, who is the final boss of Highmaul, and he also is one of the bosses in... Isn't he one of the bosses in that BC Blade's Edge raid that I'm forgetting the name of, with the Ogrons and shit? There's like one fight where it's like four ogres or whatever, and one of them's Cho'Gall. I don't quite remember. I don't know. I never raided in BC, as I've said before, so I could be completely wrong, but Cho'Gall's pretty cool. Oh, he was also in the Twilight Highlands? In the Twilight, whatever the raid is. Which, again, I'm forgetting the name, but Cho'Gall's a cool one. Because, I mean, most of his shit's relating to, like, you know, he's making deals to become more powerful. I think he's making deals. I don't know. He seems out of place to be, like, in the Twilight place. Because it's all dragon-y and shit. So I imagine that he has, like, a deal struck with the fucking brood mother. Greetings, friend. Be kind. What can I do for you? Oh, I didn't even realize that this was a fucking... this was an inn. For the Alliance. I should have, but I didn't. Blessings upon you. Alright, let's do it. Let's be a raptor! Little baby raptor! Aww, look at me. Welcome to Zul'Garub, little one. It might not look like much now, but give it time. I'm becoming Witch Doctor from Dota. Gaskeet! It's good to be home. That it is. Hello, Bloodlord Mandekin. I have killed you an obscene amount of times, sir. I hope you don't mind. By the way, I can't zoom out. I'm forced to be fully zoomed in. Yeah, this isn't close at all. Right, so here's the... You are floating. You're, like, swimming, actually. That's your swimming enemy. They're all swimming. Why are all the raptors swimming? What the hell? Also, my frame rate's not good here. As usual in ZG. Gurubashi Raptor. Rude. Alright, first mind vision complete. Oh, wait. Shit, I have to do a lot more, don't I? Hello, mon. Later. Is there nobody to sell to? I can sell to you, but you're not a repair dude. I mean, this is why I added the mammoth to my bars, but man, that's a lot of effort, you know? For the Alliance. Hello, High Encoding. What you doing here? I keep, like, it's such a default thing in my mind. Charge, victory rush. It's like, I didn't kill something before this. How am I... Where the fuck can I... Alright. Apparently that's not a way I can go. I tried. This is the one thing I tend to dislike about ZG. Or not ZG. Stranglethorn. Is that when you're climbing hills, you do not have any way of seeing anything. You just don't get to see anything. Good luck. Try fucking seeing through the trees. It doesn't work well. Okay. And the only reason that I actually grabbed this quest is because, like, I'm here anyway. Whoops. I'm here anyway, so I might as well do them all, you know? Extinguish them braziers. Is it pronounced brazier? Because brazier is like It has more than just the meaning of a fucking, you know, a big torch. At least in that pronunciation. I've always pronounced it Brazier, but I feel like that's probably incorrect. It's probably Brazier or something weird like that. Something weird and nasty. Alright. Okay. Whoops. I hit the wrong button. Whoopsies. I hit shift one. Hello. Alright, you're dead too. Was that wrong? Where's the big brain thing? Oh, it's over there. Whoopsies. Yeah, alright, I did this a bit out of order. There is a quest to kill those dudes. I'm fairly sure. For right now, we're just supposed to grab a big old brain. The nice thing about being overleveled for the content is that I don't have to aggro shit all the time. Apparently, as I say this, of course I'm immediately aggroing shit. Whoops. Oh, Jesus. Sometimes my brain does weird things and it's very frustrating. Alright, let's go over there. Yeah, but being overleveled is kind of nice, because I don't have to aggro everything as I walk. Like, they're 28, it's not like they're that far under. They are green, though. I don't know at what point quests begin to be considered low level. I think that's 10 levels above. It's clearly not 5, because these ones were not considered low level. I could have just run through those guys and hoped to not get dazed. It's weird, I haven't been dazed off my mount a single time yet on this character. Normally, when I run through enemies on a mount, it's like first hit, daze, every time, without fail. It's the only consistent thing to ever happen in World of Warcraft. Alright. Give me a moment, please. You relax, you motherfucker. I'll be seeing you. Alright, let's do it. We get to be a raptor. Alright, so here's the way we do, right? Do I have to speak with you? Nope, okay. Alright, so here's how we do. Damn it. Alright, let's try again. I actually don't remember the very first part because I never had a problem with it. I guess we just go this way. I'm fairly certain I just ran through motherfuckers and made it, but whatever. Alright, so the puzzling parts come once you get some abilities, which now we can chew through nets, which in my experience has been beyond useless, unfortunately, because they net you chew out, and then, you know, assuming you have more than one on you, I have to steal food. Assuming you have more than one on you, then they just re-net and you get caught anyway, and it's bullshit. So, this is a red herring. Herring. Yeah, except I don't like seafood, so. Never mind about the whole herring thing. Okay, I want to be able to loot through this. Because I don't want to have to deal with the pathing dudes, which are just all over, you know? Fuck off, dude. Come on, man. Hate this. Right, let's try this back tent. Those guys just pathed away. Looks like we have an opening. Sure, I'm glad I can package this raptor food into a bag. I mean, I guess they had it bagged, and in their pockets or something. I don't know. Don't you dare. It's like Metal Gear Solid, right? Except instead of being a disgruntled older gentleman, you're a tiny little baby raptor, which is adorable. Whee. It is nice though. All right, so here's when it gets like to a complete new level of bullshittery. This is when it starts getting frustrating, in my opinion. Because you have to light fire to these things to distract guys, and it's like, fuck. I guess I did the wrong thing. Also, the turn rate's very frustrating. So like, you distract them, you move away, and then you move through while they're trying to put out the fucking fire, which is all fine and dandy, but it's very finicky. Like, one time I was able to actually, like, light it up, like, you know, that far away. I didn't need to sprint, and then most of the time I have to be, like, point blank. So it's very finicky. I knew it! Oh, motherfucker! Oh, no! Come on. Shit. Can I drop aggro? Do you stop chasing? It looks like you do. Alright, let's try again. Mulligan! So get to here, do that, sprint, go, and then go through them, even though they're detecting me, it seems to be fine. All right, good. By the way, if you're trying to like level with any amount of speed, don't do this chain. Again, I'm doing this because it's fun. I enjoy this chain. Find it fucking great. Whoops. Oh, right, you just drop. I thought you threw it for some reason. Well, good. Now we get to wait like 6 minutes for this guy to fucking turn around. And we can't get too close. Like, normally I would want to like place the skull pretty much where he is right now. But in order to place it that far up, I would need to be directly behind him where he would detect me. And it's a whole thing. Oh, who put this skull here? Whoa. I do find that funny, but it is a very frustrating part, especially because these motherfuckers like to just path directly to the skull pile and then back and, you know, RP walk the whole way. And I missed my window to... No, I didn't. Okay, they're going away, so we didn't miss the window. That's good. Do-ka-do-ka-do. Shook-a-do. I do love this. The what they say before they fucking trip. First of all, the arm waving is the best part. they just look so fucking dumb. I love it. All right, so fuck, don't. Oh, thank God. Holy shit, that was terrifying actually. You motherfucker. This is the one. This is the motherfucker that ruins every fucking attempt at escaping. This is the one. Alright, I want to be on this side, I think. I just got to make sure that they don't see me on the, during the crossover. Beautiful. And I have to make sure those pathers. Good, we got there. And then I got to quickly dump this. And then I got to wait. And then I got to go. I gotta go fast. I did it! I escaped! I'm out of Zul'Garub! Oh no! Hexer, no! I got bigger plans for ya. There's Manicure. I feel like the relationship between most of these other guys in Zul'Garub and Manicure is more like, you know, Manicure is just over there masturbating onto raptors, and then everybody else is like, oh yeah, Manicure, alright. Yeah. Manicure has his ways, so, I mean, we need him, so, you know. I guess we'll just feed him little baby raptors for him to diddle.
One wishes to you.
Alright, which one of these is it much better than? Probably Demon Band. Well, yeah, because that gives more stamina. The crit's much less relevant than the stamina. So there you go.
How you doing, man?
Hey, I guess that's it. Alright, sweet. Also, I love Murdoch. Oh, this is exploring Numurgan? Yeah, fuck that shit. I love that name, though. Murdoch. It's good. It's just like Murdoch, except it's not. But it's exactly the same, except when it's not. Oh, man. Feralas. I haven't questioned Feralas in so long. I might actually cut this episode real short, because I am a bit on the tired side. And we're about to start a new area, which I might not even do. I mean, it's there, right? But, like, why is it not on my map? I mean, like, we're already, like, done, right? Cape of Stranglethorn is supposed to get me to 35. I am 34, which is more than enough because I can start Feralas, of course. Or Dustwallow Marsh, or Western Plague Lands. I don't think I've ever done Western Plague Lands. I might do that. That sounds kind of cool. I've done Eastern Plague Lands a few times on a few different characters, but I don't think I've ever done Western. Oh, I could have gotten a flight. I didn't realize because there was no marking on my map. Oh well, it doesn't matter. We're still going to get there. Everything will be okay. What mount is that? Black riding goat. You can ride goats? I guess I'm not surprised, it's just I didn't know. I guess you can ride rams, so. Speaking of rams, Swift Brewfest Ram is of course the best. By far. It's also the one that Bulf Ram Shield in Hearthstone rides, seemingly. Don't quote me on that, but it looks like it. It's the correct color scheme, I'd say.
Dunka dunka gung. How are ya?
How are ya?
Safe travels.
What's happening? Look at that repair bill. So expensive, you know? I might just, you know what? Okay, here's the plan. I'm gonna go to Booty Bay, get that flight point. And then I'm gonna queue for a dungeon, and we're gonna do a dungeon. What are the dungeons that we can queue for? RFK, Maradon. Well, we'll probably hit Maradon, which I tend to not really enjoy, but it is much better now than it used to be, now that they've sectioned it up instead of it all just being Maradon. Yeah, I'm having frame rate troubles. I might turn down the spell effects. They're on high right now, right? Yeah, particle density. Let's just turn to good. Good still gives, like, you know, a lot of the correct, correct? A lot of the good feelings about it, you know, about spell effects. It makes it feel good still. Shit, what episode is this one gonna be? This is like episode 7 or something. Holy shit, I'm recording it on night 2. Well, I will have a backlog, I'll tell you that. Quite a bit of one. Which basically means that I won't be able to actually communicate, you know, episode after episode. Like if you ask a question in episode 1, you know, you wouldn't hear the answer until episode 7. So, I probably won't do any of that sort of thing. Unless it's, like, more general questions. Which it could be, you know. So I remember the Flightmaster being in a different spot, but apparently this is the locale. that he tends to enjoy at this moment. Alright, so let's do it. Wonder what the average queue time is looking like for tank. Looks instant. Of course we have to be on the Griffin's head. It's very important. Alright, here's hoping for Razorfen, because I love Razorfen and really dislike Mardon. But we're probably gonna get Mardon, because that's my luck. At the very least, which Mardons are it? Is it, are it Wicked Grotto, Foul Spore Cavern? I think Wicked Grotto's the fastest one. The shortest chunk. There's like four chunks now, I think. Yeah, I think they split it to four chunks. Maybe it was three. I could check, but yeah, whatever. Hey, Mardon. As anticipated. Oh, Wicked Grotto. Wow. Wicked Grotto's not bad. Do I have any shouts? Battle shouts at 42. Alright. So where, oh Jesus, I forgot how to go anywhere in Mardon. Alright. I don't remember shit, man. I don't remember, alright, let's go down. Fuck it. I think it's through here, right? Yeah, this looks right. Also, remember when fucking warriors didn't get rage if the damage was absorbed? Ha, holy shit. Those sure were the fucking worst days, weren't they? God, there's so many buttons to hit. I'm to a point where I'm just like, push all of the fucking buttons and hope that they pop up in the correct order. Alright, I don't know how I feel about levitating. Thankfully, I won't be doing it for very long. Rude as fuck. Alright, excuse me, there we go. I don't want to levitate! I wish I could fucking disable. Actually, you probably can disable help in some fashion in WoW. I've just never really tried or paid attention. Why would I try, you know? It's not a big deal, but. You know, if he's gonna keep making me fucking levitate, I ain't having this shit, you know? As JonTron would say, I ain't having that shit. The fucking hunter pet bear is just floating in the air. Alright, that's unnecessary. I do, the thing that I like the most about leveling dungeons is just how fucking nice and easy it is to just sail from mob to mob. You know, there's like no downtime at all. Healers don't need to give a shit about mana even in fucking heroics. Sometimes. I mean, it depends. You know, if you're like, if your group is, you know, super overgeared or whatever, then yeah, you don't have to worry about mana pretty much ever. Oops, I didn't even realize. Alright. Motherfucking fucking stun. Fuck, shit, fuck. Alright. Oh, was that it? I guess we can be done. Right, the last guy. Yeah, alright, well, people are leaving. Well, that'll do it. I forgot how short that was. I thought it was three bosses because it looked like it there. I mean, it is, but, you know, you don't have to do the third one. He's optional or whatever. Anyway, thanks for watching. That was, like, fucking 4 minutes to do that chunk of Mardon, which is nice. I did say Wicked Grotto was the fastest, right? I'm pretty sure. So there is Wicked Grotto, Foul Spore Caverns, and Earth Song Falls. Apparently I skipped right over Scarlet Monastery for random classic dungeons, which is sad. Anyway, that'll do it for tonight, and I guess episode 7, I think. So thanks for watching. Hope you guys are enjoying the series. I am loving recording it, of course, because I do get to actually do quests and shit, which is nice. And obviously mixing it in with dungeons occasionally when I feel like it, which is also nice. Being a tank is pretty good for that. But, I mean, that'll do it. So, yeah, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next one.